You have 3 years to plan the perfect five-day hunt. We asked Greg Litzinger and Jason Michael what their plan would be to basically pick the dream absolute whitetail hunt. You have 3 years to plan it. So if you need to get points, if you need to plan, do some scouting, run trail cameras, you can execute the best five-day trip you can. Where do they go? You'll have to listen and see what their thoughts are. Comment below where your perfect five-day whitetail hunt would be in 2025. So hope you guys enjoy this conversation. Let's get right into it. Here we go.
You have 3 years to plan the perfect whitetail hunt. Where do you go? When do you go? How do you prepare? And what 5 days, we'll break it down, and then what 5 day stretch do you pick to shoot a mature buck? The reason I give you 3 years to plan it is because you can put in points. You could take some trips in the spring to do additional years of scouting. You could run cameras, and the goal is to kill a mature buck, whatever that is for that area, within a 5 day stretch.
Ooh. Wow.
Never thought of that, huh?
Yeah, no. A 3 year stretch.
Yeah. You only get a hunt for the 5 days. So in 2025, what is your plan to get to that point? Because we always, and part of it is too, a lot of people that are adopting different hunting strategies, yeah, it takes a couple years to get, yes, some momentum to where you're seeing results.
For me, that's a tough one. But 3 years to plan it, I would, yeah, say, because it's a hunt you don't ever hear anybody talk about. It'd be early season Canadian whitetails.
Really? Way out. I wouldn't have guessed that in a million years.
Yeah, I think that's probably the ultimate challenge. You got 3 years, but it's a lot of intel. I think they're in the bedding, the feeding pattern. But, mm-hmm, I mean, to shoot 180-inch deer or even just 160-inch with chocolate mass, you know.
That'd be pretty cool.
That'd be, like, super difficult. You know, I don't want to – I mean, a lot of people know I don't have dreams of hunting Iowa. No, mm-hmm, no offense. It just never really called to me, you know. So – the Canadian thing, that would probably be it. So something nuts, early season Canadian whitetails.
Okay, so like Saskatchewan or Alberta?
Wherever I know there's that big muley population, Alberta, in there somewhere. So I'd have to, wherever the more whitetails and muleys. You know? But probably Saskatchewan. Growing up, like that's, you know, when I was a kid, that's what everybody did. Everybody went to Canada for whitetails.
Yeah.
So it's always been on the back of burner, one day I want to go to Canada hunt whitetails.
And I mean, that is like the complete polar opposite of what I was – even the Canadian guys, like everybody does that in late season.
Yeah.
Yeah, complete polar opposite. Like early season. I like it.
Because, I mean, I could be completely – it could be almost possible. I don't know. But
but that's what you would do.
Yeah. You know, like, yeah. That's about as – for me, you know, I like to be – I want to be pushed to the limit, you know, whether I succeed or not. Like I want to be broke after the end of a five-day hunt. I don't want to be like, well, you know, that was kind of easy. You know, I want that to be like work.
Challenging, yeah.
Yeah. I'll go with Canadian early season whitetail.
Early season whitetail.
Nobody does that.
So what would you do to prepare for that?
I have to go to Canada.
Go to Canada and learn scout the glass. For multiple years. Yeah.
Learn the glass and learn the areas where some whitetail are. Probably find some alfalfa fields.
Yep.
You know, a lot of the rut hunts that people do up there, they're in the deep timber. They're hunting over, you know.
Pretty remote, yeah.
Yeah, usually alfalfa, like bait. So you have to find out. Be like a big wood setting, which would be super difficult. But I think it's doable. You put the work in.
Okay. And so that five-day stretch would be like the first 5 days of the season?
Yeah, that would probably be the most challenging, so yes.
I would have never guessed that. Do you have what's your quick, where would you, same scenario, where would you go, what would you do?
Yeah, mine would be Iowa.
Yeah, that's first.
I mean, but that's pretty typical, standard cop-out answer without putting.
I would also love to hunt like Idaho in the snow for whitetails, or Washington like knee-deep snow or waist-deep snow. Just something just crazy.
Yeah.
Like you might die type stuff.
Idaho has a pretty decent resident whitetail population too, man. When we were out there, like we were seeing some whitetails down
even like
down
Montana. Nobody hunts like Tim, my buddy lives out there. People don't really get into whitetails until rifle season because they can shoot them from, you know, from the road 300 yards away.
Yeah.
Like bow hunting whitetails. Like I found that when we were out there elk hunting, that 140-inch 10 pointer was a baby. Like a base is like this, but it's just this giant bladed five-point. And you're like, but nobody cares about whitetail sheds. Nobody cares about whitetails. I'm like, 160-inch deer are, there's a lot out there, you know? It's like, that's pretty cool, but
yeah, that's something that people just naturally don't think about at all.
Yeah, mule deer is bigger, you know. You got mule and whitetail, you know, 200 inches versus, you know, 160.
Right. So would you be e-scouting like crazy?
Yeah, absolutely.
In Canada for that?
Yeah, that would be
just targeting different fields.
Yeah.
So what about the biggest thing would be getting access to something like that? Where are you gonna go?
What do you mean? Like drive there or?
No, like are you going to try to get permission there? Or like I don't even know what the laws are. Do you have to hunt with someone?
Yeah, hunt as much public as possible. Uh-huh. I don't even know how Canadian public.
I think you have to, if you're hunting the Queensland, you have to have a guide.
Or a resident.
Yeah, I'd have to, look into that. Yeah. But yeah, whatever means, it's legal means necessary, I'd have to look into it.
So you have a hunt.
Okay.
3 years from now. So from today, you have 3 years to plan, scout, run trail cameras to hunt in 2025. What state are you going to go to and what 5 days is that window of opportunity going to be in?
Kentucky, super, super mega early season velvet opener. If you can get on a velvet buck over bait in Kentucky, September 2nd or 3rd for that opener and get to know those outfitters or get in with a lease or get in on a piece of ground, you can kill giant deer in Kentucky. They do it every year. That would be a key place to go with your bow or the guys at Crossbow Hunt, whatever they do there. The other one, if you took a 5-day inline muzzleloader season hunt and you hunted like the second or third or fourth full week of December and get on the right piece of ground, I know an outfitter, they really don't put you in a box hut on their 100,000 acres in Nebraska unless it's 160, but you're trying to kill 170s and 180s every night you go out. They'll take like 5 hunters a year. Now, it costs a couple bucks. Right there would be your 2 booners. That could be very possible for 10 days of hunting in 1 year. I probably, if someone said, yeah, but what about if you had to go strict public? Let's get back to the reality of the real guy that's probably listening to this podcast. But if someone said you got, in 3 years from now, you're going to go hunt for 5 days, Iowa, public ground, backup would be Kansas public ground. But my 5 days for Iowa would be the 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, and 7th of November. I'd even go out on a limb and tell you I'm going to do it in the evening. I could get on them in the morning, but I would tell you I'm going to sleep in every day and I'll kill that deer in the evening. And it won't be a 130, and it probably won't be a 140. We're going to hunt. If someone said to go somewhere to get on the best deer possible, and let's give some hope to the listener. Let's take Iowa out of the equation. Let's eliminate the long wait for the long draw. And Chad, we talked about this. We're letting some little cats out of the bag. I'd probably say, and again, it just does not get talked about. I would go key in on Eastern Central or Northern Central, Northeastern, that belt loop right there of Nebraska. I will you guys when this is over and your buddies are going to be texting you, hey, what did he tell you? Where's that spot to use the canoe, in South Dakota? And people go, you'll just never, ever, ever believe the 140 and 150 inch deer that you'd kill the week of Halloween in South Dakota. And nobody's talking about it. And I hope someday somebody goes there and kills one and said, hey, I did that. 2-3 years later, I went, gave that a try. I could promote it till I'm blue in the face. I put a booth up at the show saying, hey, this is just free information. I'm not selling a hunt. You need to all go hunt and promote it for years. And still a lot of people aren't going to go there because they're still hung up on what TV says and what you got to do. South Dakota, there's opportunities. I think you get in the right areas. It is getting hunted. I'd tell you early season, September 1, you see TV, Velvet, North Dakota. Yep. That's getting punched pretty good. But yeah, you know, Kentucky's hot. Ohio would be hot. The right areas of Tennessee are a little bit of a sleeper. Just doesn't get talked about much. The right areas of Missouri, because they come in September 15th. If you can get into the right areas of Missouri, that's an early, their opener, I believe, is September 15th. But pound for pound, yeah, I'd probably bounce around. I would, you know, it's like you mentioned it the other day. It's undoubtedly the Holy Grail, and they protect it, and it is what it is. But
so Iowa, year 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.